To best enjoy the wilderness experience, you need tranquil surroundings, clean air, a nice view, and water. Now, I've done videos on water in the past, especially people's fear of water. You know, they get all concerned where they're out in the woods. Well, where are you going to get the water, and what if it's poisonous or got bacteria and all that stuff? What I typically do when I'm going on a camping trip is I take a big 6 gallon jug like this one by Reliance. It's 6 US gallons. And I fill it up with tap water. I'm not overly fussy. It's drinking water. That works for me. And something like this usually lasts me at least a week, if not more. Now, what if you're going for longer, or what if you're just extra thirsty, I guess? You've got to have other options as well. Now, I don't drink out of this jug. Obviously, I pour it into something else. Now, a lot of people will just use little plastic water bottles, recycle them. It's not a good idea, at least for me, I don't think so, because the problem with these is when you take one drink, the bacteria on your mouth gets stuck on this little screw that's here, on this thread. And you take a drink, you put it down. If you've ever used this in a car and you've had a sip and then you leave it for 2 days and you open it up to have another sip and it's like, whoa, you know that it collects bacteria and they're harder to clean. So I don't recommend these. What I like to use is stainless steel because it's easier to clean. To sterilize stainless steel, I just pour boiling water in it, give it a little shake, and it's clean. And also, the lip is very smooth, so if you just wipe it down, you'll get a lot of the bacteria. So if you don't have a chance to wash it out, I'd recommend that. But the problem with stainless steel is it's cold, and especially like now, it's pretty cold. That's why I'm wearing all this hoodie and another hoodie underneath it. And it's cold on the hands. So what I typically like is something like this. And this one's made by Nalgene. Wide mouth bottle. It actually has a pocket insulating thing. I didn't bring it because I use this in the winter time when I'm out hiking. And if I don't have insulation around it, it freezes. But it's got a nice wide mouth. It's easy to clean. And yeah, you can pour boiling water in it, but I'd recommend at least just hot water. But it's easy to wipe it down. So that's how I carry water when I'm hiking, and how I, you know, the smaller containers I drink it out. But what about when you need to use the local water? Now, people have seen me in older videos drinking right out of a stream. I do that occasionally, but only water that I'm absolutely 100% sure what the source is and that it is clean. And that's not very common in a lot of the places I travel. But right now, it's the spring runoff. So all the water is terrible because any critters that have died during the winter, they're rotting in a stream somewhere, and any nasties are being washed off the land and into the stream. So that is the time I do not trust the water.
Even water provided at campsites may be dangerous this time of year. It's best to be prepared.
So if you ran out of water, or if you're out in the woods for an extended period of time, that means you've got to use the water that's at hand from streams, rivers, lakes, and use a filtration system.
Well, my original intention was to only test 2 water filtration systems, a Brita and a Miniwell. However, after I did those tests, I realized, oh, hold on a sec, they're not all for the same purpose. So I went back and I got a couple of more. I've got another water bottle, which is a Dobrass. I've got something I've had for a long time, this little LifeStraw. And I also got a LifeStraw water bottle adapter kit, a universal kit. So I think with these, this gives you a little bit more broader picture, and I can show you why you don't have to spend hundreds of dollars to accomplish the same thing some of the big expensive ones do.
Let's start with the simplest one, the LifeStraw Personal by Vestergaard. The packaging clearly shows it removes waterborne bacteria like E. coli and Giardia, which is essential. Another good point is there's little throwaway packaging. Pretty basic, a covered mouthpiece on one end and a filter cap on the other. Plus a strap. Yes, crouching over a stream is not convenient for everyone, and it took two hands to get the cover off and straps out of my way. It worked fine, but I think if possible, it's better to just put the water in a container first than crouch over a stream. Brita is a world-famous brand for water filtration, so including it in my review seemed a no-brainer.
And the Brita is just a water bottle with a filter inside. You fill it up with the water and let me just find it here. Here we go. There's a little nozzle on the end to drink out of. Pretty simple, basic.
Reading the instructions did not reveal anything unusual, except that in the fine print it had expected reduction levels of chlorine and particulate, but no mention of bacteria. It wasn't until later, when I looked at the tiny print on the outside packaging I threw out, that I saw the hidden disclaimer. Do not use with water that is microbiologically unsafe. Why could they have not just said in big letters, not intended for outdoor use? That would have been great info to know before I dipped the bottle into the stream. I think it's ironic that the key slogan on their packaging is, "Get ready to drink smarter." Didn't seem to apply here. Fortunately, I did not get any of the side effects. The Dobrass water filter bottle claims a chemical-free portable water filter system. But it also states that it removes 99.9999% bacteria, and I quote, of protoza, which is really a bad translation of removes bacteria and protozoa. Bad English aside, it was a slick product with little to do but just remove it from the box. And it included a straw and clip.
Well, the Dobrass is a lot easier to use because you don't have to crouch right down to the water. All you have to do is take off the lid and the filter, fill it up with water. Release the nozzle, and you're ready to drink. Tastes clean.
I was really impressed with the cap design, as with just one finger, the mouthpiece flips up rapidly, but the best part was that the mouthpiece was protected from outside elements when not in use and locks for security. As a bonus, hidden under the lid is a secret compass. Not essential, but I just appreciate the ingenuity. Now, as far as versatility at a reasonable price goes, one has to consider the Miniwell Portable Water Filter L630. The small packaging means less plastic to throw out and includes the filter, a connector, a hose clip, and the hose. I really appreciated the easy-to-read manual, complete with color photos. Not only did they clearly show you what bacteria they filter, the capacity and the shelf life, they also have easy setup and maintenance instructions. Another trip to the stream for a little dirty water. Crouching over the edge had the undesired bonus of soaking the bottom of my hoodie.
Tastes like water!
But to be versatile, I needed to try it out in different ways. I had an old soda bottle I could use to hold water.
Ooh, that's cold!
And the Miniwell happened to incorporate the same thread in their design. Smart.
Works.
You could use any size pop or soda bottle for this, but I preferred a big one for volume. Now here's a blooper. Watch the bottle cap.
Cap.
Hey, nobody's perfect. Now the concept of carrying dirty water around to fester just didn't really appeal to me. I preferred to store clean, drinkable water. Squeezing the soda bottle seemed to work fine, but I'm lazy sometimes. Why not just let gravity take over? But since there was no airflow, that was really slow. I needed a more practical option, one especially for campers. I found an ice cream pail worked good and made a 9/16 of an inch hole towards the bottom. Using the supplied connector, I removed the cover and one washer and pushed the connector through the hole. I added the other washer, screwed in the cover until everything was sealed. Now all I needed was the hose, clamp, and filter. It was time for another visit to muddy waters. Use whatever method is available to elevate the bucket. I used an old fallen tree. To use, unlock the hose clip . Pop off the mouthpiece cover and the water starts flowing. How fast it pours depends on how much water is in the bucket and how clean your filter is. I speeded up the camera here, but it took about 2 minutes to filter 32 ounces of water. The last system is another LifeStraw setup called the Universal. It included a lid, bag, and filter, plus caps for two different sizes of bottles. And yes, the labeling not only states it removes bacteria and parasites, but it also reduces chlorine and improves taste.
And I haven't even opened it. I hope I can get it open. Probably gonna take me a sec. I'm gonna have to tear it. And the reason I like this, and I didn't try the filter. Whoa, lots of plastic, that's not good. I'm sure the filter works because it's a LifeStraw, but what I liked about this is it's good for other bottles. Like my favorite one here, it has an adapter for it. All I have to do is put the filter on, which would be like that, put it in, and now I can use my favorite bottle with a LifeStraw filter. And it also has, oh, gotta find it here, a new cap.
The key to keeping these filters working properly is maintenance. LifeStraw in particular mentioned that to clean their products, you blow your breath through the mouthpiece to backwash the filter and remove water and residuals. I'm not convinced this is sanitary. For the Miniwell system, I propose a different approach. Put a little water you already cleaned in a bottle, hold it against the rubber gasket on the inlet, and flush the filter by squeezing the bottle. This seems much more cleaner to me. A little shakedown, and you're done.
Well, I think that's a pretty fair comparison, because the water out here, certainly this time of year, is indeed suspicious. If you have to drink the water, you should filter it. And I think I gave a good general assessment of these products, at least. So, what was the winner and what was the loser? Well, one that is a total fail is the Brita. And it's simple. It's not meant for water in the wilderness. This is meant strictly for tap water. It removes the taste of chlorine. So for outdoors, please do not use. As for the Dobrass, actually I like the concept. It's relatively inexpensive. This is all you need to get water. It's great for the trail and stuff like that. I really like this part here. The mouthpiece, it pops up. And I know LifeStraw has something similar for a little bit more money, but the thing about the LifeStraw one is it doesn't protect the mouthpiece. This one does, and that is a good feature. You just use it and you drink. It's that simple. The portable LifeStraw, it's fine. It works. Of course, you have to crouch down every time you need water, so it's no good for filling containers. Fits in your pocket. I like the strap because, yeah, if you drop it in the stream, there it goes. But the one I liked the most definitely was the Miniwell, because it does the same thing as the LifeStraw, but it's smaller, easier to fit in your pocket. And with the other features, you can use it on a bucket or a big bag, and yes, you can fill up all the water you need for camping. And if you're with a trailer as opposed to just going out on a day hike, that's important.
But of course, this is only one man's opinion. Feel free to pick the best option for yourself.
But I hope that gives you enough information you can make a reasonable decision. And by the way, if you're ever unsure of the water, even if it's filtered, there's a third thing you can do. Boil it. And by the way, all of these items I purchased with money out of my own pocket or through the people that have donated. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. No sponsorship. It's a clean slate. I could test anything as long as I can afford it. And that's the big thing. If you have any suggestions, please put them in a comment. But don't send me any links. They get filtered out and I miss them. I hope you enjoyed this. Please check out my other videos as well. I'm gonna have a drink. Good water.
Please check the video description for more info on these products. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Happy camping!